Cronin Toyota and Cronin Nissan are honored to partner with Proudly We Served, as well as the continued support of our local active and retired military veterans across eastern Indiana.
Now, therefore, I, David M. Snow, as the mayor of the city of Richmond, do hereby proclaim Monday, May 27, 2019, as Memorial Day in the city of Richmond. And I call upon all citizens in this community to reflect and pay homage to those who have contributed mightily to preserve the principles of justice, freedom, and democracy that we so cherish. Thank you all so much for being here today, and thank you to all of our veterans who have served our country. Thank you.
At this time, we're going to have the POW MIA wreath placed by Marshall Smith and Ron Hill. Thank you. Now Cindy Slick is going to come back and sing another song called Arlington.
Never thought that this is where I'd settle down. Gave me this plot of land, me and some other man, for child building. There's a big white house, it's on the hill, just up the road. And the man beside it cried the day they brought me home. They folded up the flag and told my mom and dad, proud of your son. We made it to
our guest speaker today, and I've been kind of going back and forth for the last couple of weeks, and so I said, well, how do you want me to introduce you? And so he sent over a resume. So I sent him back a message, and he'll verify this is true. I said, we don't have all day. We got a small window. But what I'd like to say is that Command Sergeant Major Jim Brown started his military career in 1969 with the U.S. Army as a squad leader of Company D, 501st Infantry Division in Vietnam. Jim then joined the National Guard and served there for 10 years. Later, Jim served as Command Sergeant Major of the 293rd Infantry, 76th Infantry, 38th Infantry, State Command Sergeant Major of Indiana. In 2009 through 2010, Jim served in Afghanistan as Command Sergeant Major of the Regional Corps Training Team, Operation Freedom, living with the Afghanistan Army. Upon return, Jim served 2 years and retired as a State Command Sergeant Major. Some of Jim's awards include the Army Distinguished Service Medal, the Legion of Merit, the Bronze Star with V Device, the Purple Heart, the Air Medal, the Arvin Gallantry Medal with Bronze Star. The Arvin is the Armed Forces of Vietnam. Combat Infantry Badge, Vietnam. Combat Action Badge, Afghanistan. There's more to Jim's story than what I've just said, but you know, to me, he's just simply a friend. And that's the way I'm going to introduce him, my friend, Jim Brown.
Thanks, Al. Thanks for inviting a city boy. I got my coat on, and y'all don't. I'm also aware that a lot of people are standing, and it's hot out here. So I ain't going to talk very long. Now I'm going to scare the bejeebers out of you by pulling out some notes. But I'll go fast, because I grew up in L.A., and so I can't read. So it won't take very long. I got to say, looking at the hue here, because I've done everything, jumping out of a Huey, wouldn't want to fly one, that's pretty impressive. More so are the people on the ground, so in the Army with boots on the ground, that this community has showed up, because it's God and country and community and everything that, just like the chaplain said, the fabric that makes us the United States. In each small town or city, or big cities, they're having services today because we love America. And we'll defend it, and that's why we're here today. So it's an honor to be here. Thanks for letting me talk for a couple minutes. So I want to say I've seen some people I know, so almost all of you can come up and just talk, because you were in the same situation I was at. So I got picked today. So I'll just kind of run through it. So if I don't look up like they teach in speech class at the Sergeant Major Academy, you'll want me to just keep going. So it's an honor to be here, see all of you today, to honor those that have gone on before us, these that have paid the ultimate sacrifice for their state and their nation. That we meet here today in this city and across the nation, towns and cities, to pay our respects, to honor those that have served, and to remember, which is what I do almost every day at age 70 now, is remember. I take walks. There's some twilight stuff in the infantry. You were pretty quiet in Vietnam and long about twilight time. So I remember that, and the dedication and the heroes that put themselves out under fire to get a job done and then were cut down. Some of them, they end up dying in your lap. Things have to happen to get it done, as you all know, each one of us in our tasks. But to look at back and to see again the faces of the young men and women who gave up their tomorrows in order that we might be free people to enjoy our todays. So the United States of America, as it moves towards its 300th year as a republic, those who we honor today, all the way back, paid the price to keep our liberty with their blood. So I want to sit there just for a second. So there can be an 18-year-old kid saying, who asks about his mom as he's fading away. He would like to live longer. And he also wants to know about the Lord. These young people in all these wars, from Valley Forge forward, they've put out the last full measure. That hasn't missed it with me. I got it, and that's why I'm here today. It's not, I'm just like you, other than I've been seared with that commitment, and it'll stay with me. So God bless these and the families. I wrote this at 4 o'clock this morning, so it's real fancy, but I know of the Gold Stars. We, as the Division Command Sergeant Major and the state CSM, with Katrina in between, the state produced over 170 deployments of different sizes. Nine of them had, we sent generals and large commands. So we made that commitment. For me, I was brought up by my grandfather. He would take me, I'm from Los Angeles. So I've been here 49 years, so don't beat me up in the parking lot. So I'm gonna get him, he ain't from here. So he'd take me to watch the Korean War veterans in the march on the parade. They had been home 2 or 3 years. National Guard unit that was sent, that was called for by Douglas MacArthur. So they were gone a couple of years. So they're marching, and then meeting at the park, in a corner of the park, there were white crosses. I'm like 8 years old. And so behind the crosses are the World War I vets. They're in their 60s and 70s, standing like, looking like eagles with leather skin. And the World War II vets were there. They let the young'uns, as they call the Korean vets, do the marching. Well, I learned then, and with those decorations and the commitment and those close memories, even from World War I, what it meant to serve your country, the sacrifice and the price that we pay, family by family, individual by individual. So it taught me a lot, and it stayed with me until this day. So America, from Valley Forge, where Washington didn't get Congress to give them money for boots, all the way with all our failings as a country and mistakes as we do along the way, it's the people that serve that comprise the dedication. So it's us. And then our fine flag, what could it say if the flag could talk? It's a pretty proud old flag, a grand old flag. So Lincoln said that as long as we Americans love liberty more than ourselves, the United States, these United States, as he said, would remain free. He went on to say that if America ever lost its way and fell as a nation, it would be because we fell from within, that we'd lost that love for liberty. Not in this town. Not in this town. Don't come in here with your loss of liberty in this town. The mayor's going to grab you and call the police. And then some motorcyclists are going to show up about 10 minutes later, ask you where you're from. So I love this community, and so you're applauding yourselves. You make up what this community is. You should be darn proud. So these days as a boy, and you're going, when is he going to quit? Just a minute or two. Then later I became a soldier, served in Vietnam, took that soldier's oath. Well, if you'll read that oath, there's some words in there that kind of says, and you're standing there with a buck-tooth kid, doesn't have a comb over yet, but you're going, what did he just say? And I said those words. You're going to give your life to your country if you have to. Some captain said, you, 1st Platoon, you go on the right of those other boys, and you support them, and people are getting knocked down by fire. It's like, that's what that oath means. is in that day, for your moment, you have to maybe go around, leave that rock, that comfort behind one of them jungle trees, and go do your job. And it's costly, as I've already mentioned. And perhaps give your life for your country. There's no greater honor, and I know that we all know that here in the families that are here. I can see the lady that raised her hand back over here to my 10 o'clock, maybe 9:30. So serving with the 101st, we had a lot of experience out in the jungle, and I was going to mention that. So all I want to do now is mention that, instead of reading that, I just want to tell you that lifting off from LZ Sally with like a bunch of 30 Hueys with door gunners, who hopefully they didn't drink last night, the aviation, they got their crew rest maybe. Here we go launching in a big long line, kind of an arc, like a fish hook, and we're making that turn and our feet are outside the door. And here's this hilltop that we're gonna land on, and it's going like this. It's the dirt flying in the air, that's the artillery strike. Then Marine fast movers came out and dumped a lot of, as they moved out, because they got to watch it with the artillery being done. And so here comes the napalm. Nobody likes that, because it takes all the oxygen out of the air. So stay with me here. This is my only war story. So we turn that corner, and in you're coming, and starting to slow down to land that puppy, and they're under fire. Bullets are flying. So the Cobras open up with their miniguns, and then they fire rockets. And they're peeling off, spitting 44 Mike grenades underneath their belly. So no one wants that. So you don't shoot the rear end of the helicopter as they leave. So we land, and so we had the enemy on the landing zone. We lost people there. And their technique was let a couple of these fellers come in, then shoot down the third one. So now you can't get in the jungle. And so there's the enemies running along. Beside the trail to the landing zone, because that was the Ho Chi Minh Trail. And they're trying to fire an RPG at you. And the door gunner got this one guy that I was looking at. So and then they go away, everybody goes away, and then it's real quiet, and it's like, man, we're in trouble. So that'll make you turn to the Lord. And that's what I did, and I'm going to mention that. If I don't, then I made a deal with the Lord. He'd let me live. I'd always respect that and become a Christian, but I also said that I wouldn't be ashamed to claim that. So I am today. So I survived that and joined the Guard, had a wonderful experience there, and it lasted 30 years, which is more than 10 now. I'll get you for that. Maybe some push-ups would help and flutter kicks. Couple laps around this joint. And then after knowing the units as a senior NCO, we were deploying them, I had three of my CSMs that were killed in Afghanistan, so I resigned and went to serve over there as a senior leader. So I was with the 82nd and then the 101st. And so I just want to say you'd be so very proud of the young men and women and the Army and all the services that are there, and they do a combined arm. So this just isn't the Army, it's everybody, even those bullies, the Marines. There's a couple of them back here, so Al, you watch them, I'll talk up here. So they just want to get you. So, but the young men and women, I went to 58 funerals with Governor Daniels at the time. And then seeing them serve, they're just like the World War II crowd, the greatest generation. So it's today's generation. It's the great generation for now. And remember about if we fall from within, those comments, we will not fall from within as the next generation signs up, takes that oath in any one of these services and has that moment going, what did he just say? Like that. We'll remain strong as long as we have our priorities right for this nation and its principles. So my admiration for you is that y'all here, y'all came, and maybe you're gonna have a barbecue later, and I hear there's some beans somewhere over VFW beans. So I gotta get back after this because my wife broke her leg in four places at Walmart's 3 days ago. So she had asked me where I was going this morning. So I wanna say, God bless you all. And God bless the state, our armed services. Those are, so my son-in-law is in Afghanistan, his ninth deployment. He's a colonel. And I have another son-in-law who's on the Iraqi-Syrian border right now doing his third deployment. So they're out there, like, as you all know, and as you've all seen, that then there's this cloud over the family that has their loved ones gone. And then we can lose them, and we have to, they now have become a fabric, a piece of fabric on that flag. They're part of America, or we won't make it as America without this dedication that we're talking about and alluding to, those that have paid the sacrifice. So God bless those that have lost people, those that have people far and away, and then we just can't do enough for our families. And there are things that linger after war, killing and all the things that, that happen to us that cause strife and turbulence in the home and in the family. Family's back home. There's a lot going on there. So we need to be aware of that in our churches and in our prayers. So thanks again for being patient and listening to me, and God bless all of you. Thank you, Al.
If you get the chance, and Jim can stand around for just a little bit, go up to him and just talk to him. He's the real deal. I mean, he just knows his stuff, and I've just really learned to respect him for what he's done and serving in Vietnam. At this time, we're going to have our closing ceremony for the Memorial Day ceremony. I'm going to turn it over to Jim Hall and the Honor Guard and the Civil War veterans, and they're going to do our closing ceremony. Father God, we thank you for a beautiful day that you've given us to be able to honor the memory of our comrades. We ask God that we not take this in vain, God, that we realize the seriousness of the commitments that were made, the lives that were given, and the families that lost their loved ones. We ask now, God, as we part to go our various ways, that we cherish the memories in our heart and that we not allow them to burden or sadden us, but God, that we remember the good times, the good days, and we reflect on those. And God, may we be drawn together as a family. Because one thing I learned in my 24 years in the military, doesn't matter what branch you're in, we are all one family. So help us to remember that, God. And should we see a brother or sister in need, God, let us, Lord, just be wanting to help and to support. Now we ask your blessings and protection as we travel on the road, and we just ask for your glorious riches to be upon us and with us, and I pray it in Jesus' name, amen.
Thank everybody for coming. The cannon's going to fire shortly.
Thanks. What's the interval and why?
1 minute. It's a national salute. You fire it twice a year, one shot a minute for 21 minutes. You fire it on Memorial Day and Washington's birthday. It's only two times you can fire it.
10 seconds.
February is too cold to fire it.
I agree with that. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, bang.
Cronin Toyota and Cronin Nissan are honored to partner with Proudly We Served, as well as the continued support of our local active and retired military veterans across eastern Indiana.